I just wanted to come on right quick. Hope you guys are having a great Sunday. Hope you make it to somebody's church. Yeah, amen. I've been going through some of my old videos. So like, it's crazy. Like, yeah, I do all these videos. You know, the whole purpose of these videos is to share different moments with God that I'm having with God, share my walk with God, sharing like the different things that God has done for me to want to increase other people's faith, but also so that I have a record to then look back on to see how God has been faithful and God has been merciful, God has been loving, and God, you know, all of that, you know. And so the thing is, I've never really watched my videos, to be honest. Like, I just don't. But I was watching some of the old ones and just remembering, like, at the beginning of the year, some of the things I was, you know, believing God for. At the beginning of the year, I had a whole lot of videos talking just about trusting God with my finances. I was having all those issues, like, with plumbing and all that kind of stuff, because, like, I was having a whole bunch of issues with that and how it was costing me a lot of money and how I was learning to trust God with my finances. And God saw me through that whole period of time where I was having to spend a crap ton of money on bills. And like, but regardless, like, I still, in that time period, I never had a lack. I never needed for anything. Like, it was crazy because, like, at the beginning of the year, God wanted me to sow a really big seed. So not only that, I sold a really big seed that I had really originally planned to use that money to go on different conferences throughout the year. And then all the stuff with my plumbing, like, I'm getting water bills that are, like, $200, $250, you know, every month for, like, it was, like, 3-4 months at a time. And then having to pay for the plumbers to come out every single time. So that's another $75 every time they came out. And, like, how much money I spent, I had to spend just to get that whole situation. I never was without groceries. I was never late on the bill. I was never, you know, like, all my needs were literally taken care of. And the thing is like, when you're generous and you have a heart of generosity, God rewards that. When you sow those seeds, God rewards that. God gives you that back 110, 30, 60, 100-fold. I don't know the exact verse, but you guys know it, right? And so, like, originally, that money that he told me to sell, Milo, please, I'm on the video. When, you know, he told me to sell it, originally that money was going to go towards conferences and stuff. And, like, literally this year, I went on to more conferences than I have ever. Like, I went to so many different conferences. I bought so many different courses. Like, I literally, like, reflecting on it, I went to Millions Conference. I went to Pioneer Girls. I went to the spiritual development school. I bought Marshall Edwards course. I got courses from Dr. Faith. I got courses from Keisha Cephas. Like, I got so many things. So, like, everything I wanted, every class I wanted to take that would help me grow spiritually, like, I was able to buy it. I was able to, like, have it. So, like, at the end of the year, it's like, wow, I was faithful, like, and giving God that, like, handing over that seed to God, and he didn't give me the return. Like, everything I wanted to do, what I wanted to do with that money still happened. And so I just wanted to encourage you guys. Like, I know a lot of times, especially, like, income tax season is about to come up around again, and you're about to get these refunds. Like, ask God, what does he want you to do with that money? Because I know you got plans, probably pay some bills off to buy something, you know, you've been wanting for a while or whatever it may be. But ask God, what does he want you to do with that money? And why? And then actually do it. And then watch God, how he supplies for you and gives you your heart's desires throughout the rest of the year. It says, the verse says, delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you your heart's desire. Delight in the Lord, obeying him, doing his will, committing yourself to him. That's what delight in the Lord means. And he will give you your heart's desires. My heart desire was to go to different conferences. And, like, I was going to use that money for that. But I gave it to God instead, and he in return allowed me to still have the funds to be able, like, money just came out of nowhere, and I was able to pay for all these conferences. So I just want, like, that's the perks of being generous, the perks of having a heart of generosity. The more you give out, the more God can then pour back into you. So I just wanted to encourage you guys on that. Guys, I am out of that funk. You know, I was telling you, I think it might have been the last video, like, I was just in this funk where I was very much, the last video was list paralysis, and basically, there was so much for me to do, so much I could do, that I was pretty much stuck not being able to do anything. I'm out that funk, thank God. And, like, I really started seeing the turnaround this week. Like, at one point, like, throughout that time, like, no matter how I felt, I still kept pushing. I was like, I'm going to do something. I'm going to accomplish something. Or, like, you know, even if that something was waking up, going to work, going back home, like, that was something, that was an accomplishment on some of those days that were really tough for me. But as I kept pushing, I kept pushing, that allowed me to kind of build myself back up. So it's just like, I went from, well, I haven't done anything today, to, well, at least I got this done. Well, at least I had this done, to like, oh, wow, I got this done too. Oh, wow, I'm on the road now. It's like, okay, I can do something else. And that's when it switched for me. Like, when, as soon as I started thinking, okay, what else can I do? That's when the whole thing, like, just broke off of me. And so I just want to encourage you guys, like, especially at the end of the year. I know for me, I have, like, a lot of reporting to do for my job. You know, it's Christmas season, so you have a lot to do with that. If you feel like, oh, I just feel this heaviness, like I can't keep going, just keep pushing. Keep striving towards something. Even if it's not as productive as you wish you were, it's something. That is still proud. The fact you still continue to wake up and do your normal routine, that's something. Count that as something. That's what I talked about in my last video. Like, those little things that we kind of take for granted, like, oh, well, only thing I did today was go to work. You went to work. Some people didn't even, couldn't get out of bed to get go to work. So the fact that you was able to do that is something. And a lot of those small moments kind of like build you up. So, yeah, that's pretty much all I want to talk about right now, at least. I'm on my way. I'm about to leave for church right now. So, yeah, I hope you guys have a great day. And I just want to just encourage you guys, like, just keep pushing. Like, it's what, 10, 15, 16 more days of the year. Like, you can accomplish a lot. I know, like, we make all these big, grand goals for our year, and like, I know it's like at the end of the year you start reflecting like, wow, I really didn't get to do that, I really get to do that. You got 16 days, you can make progress, you can start. 16 days is enough to start. And yeah, you might not reach that goal, you might not complete that test, but to start is something too. So start your 2020 with, you've already started something from 2019. So if your goal was to lose weight, go start getting, go to get that gym membership now. Don't wait till the first, get it now. So then that's one less thing you have to do. So you've started your goals already. If your goal was to, like, save a certain amount of money, open up a savings account, put a dollar in it. You started. Yeah, you might not have completed that task, but at least you started. If your goal was to get more organized, go buy a planner. I mean, that's best, or like whatever it is, like however you're trying to get organized, like make those small steps now. So at the beginning, and that's even if you have goals. And so you make goals for 2019, but you want to make goals for 2020. Start now. Don't put all that pressure on yourself to start that at the, on the first, because it's a lot of pressure and it feels like, oh, it'll make you feel overwhelmed. And if you don't hit it that first day, you feel like it'll make you feel like, oh, I can't do it. Like, I originally set out, this is how I kind of got into list paralysis in the beginning. At the beginning of the end of November, I kind of set out, okay, this is what my schedule looks like. Like, I looked at like a time schedule. So, like, every hour, I did it actually by half hours from midnight to 11:59 p.m. and like allocating different slots from like my time. So like this block of time at work, this block I commute, this block I do this, you know, all that stuff, right? And so then I saw how, okay, one, I was wasting a lot of time. Like a lot of stuff you say you want to get done, you really have the time to get done. It's just that you might waste time, you know? And so by actually scheduling out that time, you can then like hold yourself more accountable, right? And the thing was, it's like, I realized, okay, I have time to go to the gym 4 times a week for an hour. I don't go to the gym because I don't want to. That's really the end of it. At first, I was telling myself, oh, I don't have time. I'm like, no, you have time. You just don't want to. And so I was like, okay, I'm going to switch this thing around. I'm going to start going back to the gym. Because what's the point of me paying for a gym membership if I ain't going, right? And so, but December 1st, I was going to start this new schedule, right? December 1st was like, was it a Sunday or Monday? It was a Sunday. So, yeah, December 1st was a Sunday. That was too much pressure, and so I missed that Sunday. A lot happened, and I didn't make it to the gym. I was supposed to also go grocery shopping. There's a grocery store right next door to the gym, and I was supposed to meal prep. I didn't do none of that, and so then I felt like, wow, I couldn't. Then I felt like, oh, I've already been productive. I've already been defeated, so I can't do this. And so that's kind of what the start of my whole list paralysis was. Like, I have the schedule, but I've already missed this day. So there's no point in me doing the next. And, you know, that's how we get that. That's that lie that the enemy tells us. Like, oh, you already missed day one, or you didn't succeed or whatever, so you can't do it. And so it's not until I was like, you know what? No, I'm making progress. So you actually have to take that lie and, like, say, no, that's not true. That's not what the word of the Lord says. The word of the Lord is that I'm victorious, that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And God strengthens me. So that means I can do all things. So, yeah, I might not have made it on December 1st, but I could have started back on December 2nd had I changed my mindset. So I'm saying all this to say, having that goal for the first can be put a lot of pressure on you. And the enemy uses that pressure that you're already putting on yourself to make you feel like you can't accomplish anything. So instead, start a couple days earlier. Start now. Start this week. Start in the next week, I guess. I don't know. I have a calendar right here. That's what I'm looking at. So yeah, you can do it this week. You can do it next week, right? Start now. Or start, like, let's say you have 3 goals: finances, spending time with God, and like weight loss or something. Let's say those, eating healthy, some type of lifestyle type goal, right? We'll start one this week, and then by halfway through, start the next one. The next week, start the next one. So you can stagger them, so you're not overwhelmed, so you're not doing 3 big goals all at once. So, yeah, we went off on a tangent, but I hope you guys got something out of that. I hope you guys have a great day. And I just want to encourage you guys, don't be so hard on yourself. Like, it's okay. You got this. Like, and slow progress is still progress. I said that in the post I posted a couple of days ago. And sometimes I know me personally, talking about myself, I don't give myself credit for the small things. It's like it has to be a big task where I can say, okay, Alana, you did that. Like, no, the fact that you're still pushing, even when you don't want to, is something. And so I just want to encourage you guys just to keep going, to end this year off the way you want it to be. And don't let anybody else or society tell you what the end of your year should look like. So I hope you guys have a great day. I will talk to you guys soon.